In our world today, we have been developing ourselves and our society with technology. What is technology? Technology is the use or the process of using scientific ideas and systems so that we can use it for our daily life and apply it for any practical purposes. Now look at our country, the Philippines. Bright, colorful, and free. Now what technology do you think that symbolizes us Filipino? For me, it is the jeepney. The jeepney is a technological staple and it symbolizes us Filipino and our society today. It can be used for transport or for moving large quantities of any materials. Most of us know that a jeepney is a staple yet powerful and effective way of transport in our society in the Philippines. It serves as a symbol for us, our transport systems, and a symbol of our culture and traditions, as the colors and designs vary from jeepney to jeepney. So, how about we look for a more overlooked or obscure inventions from the Philippines? An invention so small yet effective it is used all over the world. These inventions are made by one person named Diosdado P. Banataw. So, who is Diosdado P. Banataw? Diosdado or Dado P. Banataw is born in May 23, 1946, in the town of Iguig, Cagayan, Philippines. He studied at Mapoy Institute of Technology and graduated as a cum laude. After college, he worked as a design engineer at Boeing and turned down a lot of jobs, such as companies from Meralco and the Philippine Airlines. After that, he took his master's degree in science in electrical engineering at Stanford University in 1972. At that time, Banataw joined the Home Computer Club and met Steve Jobs, the CEO of Apple, and Steve Wozniak. After finishing his degree, he worked with different tech companies. That time when he worked with different companies, he designed the first single chip. So, what is different about this single chip from other chips? This chip has a GUI. So, what is a GUI? A GUI is an interface where a user interacts with the machine. So, rather than looking at codes and binary numbers to work with a computer, you instead see different pictures, square, check, or X, signifying yes or no. This GUI has been evolved from time to time until we have the modern phone and the computers we have today. The GUI remains as a staple product of all technology, rather than using binary code to show how a machine interacts with a person, we use different colored images to convey a meaning, such as a red button remains no, or a green button remains yes. If you choose yes or no, it will click with a sound button. That is a GUI. It is a facade for the real work for the computer. He also developed a 10 megabit Ethernet for the company Seek Technology. Banataw is most known for his invention of the single logic chip from IBM's computer, which is the same single chip which is used for the processes of the computer. The concept of a USB, the concept of using an external storage that you can carry all around, and the most notable is the Windows Graphics Accelerator in personal computers. This graphics accelerator all about? The graphics accelerator is used all over the world today. It is the most used piece of technology, and today it is called a GPU. The word GPU sparks some idea, right? Some of you know it, some of you don't. A GPU is what makes our phones render images, our computers render images, videos, or etc. So, what is the difference of a GPU and good old CPU? A CPU is powerful but slow in rendering, but a GPU is not that powerful but it's so good at rendering. For example, if a puzzle is placed versus a GPU and a CPU, the CPU might think for a second on what puzzle will be first and will put the puzzle sequential by 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5. Like that. How about a GPU? A GPU is not that, but it is powerful at rendering. So a GPU who has many hands or many threads in their compartments, which speeds up the processes of finishing the image. So what is the point of his invention?
what is the point of the GPU? So, all of his invention, I understand that his invention is all about speed and efficiency. His works, such as the single chip, is all about speed. The 10 megabit Ethernet is all about speed. The USB, it's all about speed and efficiency. The Windows graphics accelerator is the most efficient thing in the world. It is used for everything that exists right now. So if the product or the invention of Banatao is so impactful in our society, why didn't his product become popular and mainstream? Let's tackle number one. He worked in a company. Companies make you think that they created a product. The CEO of the company believes that they created something. It is all because of anchoring bias. They use that. So what is anchoring bias, by the way? Anchoring bias is all about the human system, how we rely on the first information we get. Example, they use this bias to implement an idea that they made the product. So the next time you think about the idea, the company will come up to your mind. Example, the iPhone, it was made by Apple. It is made by Tim Cook. No, it is made by the Apple engineers on Apple, rather than the company itself. Next is number two. It is small. So, the GPU is so small. Some GPU are like 1 millimeter thick. It means it can fit in your phone. So, why is it in mainstream, by the way? Because it is part of a phone. It is just a component. Components invention is not that popular because people think about the product. They think about the final product. They don't think what is inside. They don't think what is the most complex thing. They don't think of anything. They only think of the final result. That is what humans like. They want results. They want a product. So, a component doesn't make it mainstream because it is just a component for a product. So what did we learn today? We learned that Diosdado Banatao is the most overlooked inventor today. He revolutionized technology by giving means of speed and efficiency. Today, his works are used everywhere. To the computer that renders this video, documents, and the video that you can watch on your phone. His works are amazing, and we should be proud of it. Especially in a world where we need to be safe from COVID-19 sickness. His works are amazing and changes society as we know it. Imagine a school where you cannot do any educational works online because computers are slow and buggy. Let us be proud of the fact that a Filipino helped change the world and technology. Let us be proud to be Filipino and appreciate the big things and the small things that us Filipinos created.